We're here this afternoon to announce the indictment of seven individuals, seven members of a major interstate gun trafficking ring that allegedly trafficked more than 30 firearms, including prohibited AK-47s, prohibited AR-15 assault rifles from Ohio into New Jersey, where they were illegally sold to criminal elements here in Camden, New Jersey. In fact, a number of those guns trafficked by this very ring were involved in a number of violent crimes in Camden over the last several years. In total, during the course of the investigation, 17 guns linked to this weapons trafficking ring were recovered, including the two assault rifles that I just mentioned, as well as 14 handguns, which included a number of semi-automatic pistols that were equipped with illegal high-capacity magazines. Unfortunately, the residents of this city are all too familiar with the misery that these deadly weapons can inflict when put in the hands of gang members, drug dealers, and other violent criminals. Camden has too many tragic memories to illustrate this point. In some cases, the victims of gun violence in Camden are misguided individuals involved in criminal activity who think that with a gun in their hand, that they're too tough to kill, until another person with a gun in their hand kills them. In other cases, the victims are innocent bystanders, such as 8-year-old Gabby Hill Carter, who was caught in the crossfire of a dispute between rival drug gangs and fatally shot as she played outside of her home in Camden in August of 2016. In a city where drug dealers will recklessly spray 14 rounds from an AK-47 across a park and hit a bus carrying preschoolers, as happened in September 2013, the fear of guns and the fear of gunfire really never goes away. While Chief Thompson and the Camden County Metro Police, working with their law enforcement partners, working with their community partners, engaging in innovative and collaborative community policing efforts, have made extraordinary and commendable progress since 2012 in reducing gun violence here in Camden, as mentioned earlier, reaching a 30-year low in 2017 in the number of murders recorded, we cannot and we must not become complacent in our efforts. These dangers will remain as long as criminals have easy access to the type of lethal firearms trafficked by these seven defendants. That is why, to reduce gun violence in our communities, and to reduce the threat to our communities, and to reduce the threat to our law enforcement officers from assault rifles and other illegal firearms, we need to stop the flow of illegal guns into our state. And that starts with dismantling organized rings such as the one uncovered in this case. And that is why this investigation in particular, and others like it, are so important. Simply put, each gun that we seize or take off the street is a life or multiple lives that we save in the process. Now, while Director Honig will provide you with additional details regarding the charged offenses, those charged in this case include the alleged leader of this ring, Chucky Scott of Columbus, Ohio, his alleged straw purchaser, Anthony Hammond. That's the individual with the clean record who's able to walk into gun stores in Ohio or go online and buy firearms that were trafficked into this area using middlemen, who are also on the boards to my left, middlemen who lived in or near Camden and acted as the wholesalers of these guns. And they include a drug dealer, a heroin supplier named Eduardo Caban, two cousins of Scott, Eric Moore and Tymir Jennings, two other associates, Jamar Folk and Darren Harville. There are a number of charges in this case, but what's important to remember is that all seven defendants in this case are charged as a criminal enterprise with racketeering, first-degree racketeering, and that charge alone carries a sentence of 10 to 20 years in state prison, including a period of parole ineligibility of 85% of the sentence imposed if the individuals are convicted at trial. These potential sentences should serve as fair warning to anyone who would think about trafficking firearms into this state, They should serve as a warning that we will aggressively prosecute you, we will aggressively try you, and we will seek strong deterrent sentences. And wherever appropriate, we will also work with our federal partners who are behind me and with federal prosecutors, because if it's more appropriate to charge these cases in federal court, if the sentences are more severe in federal court, we will seek and we will pursue those sentences. That's my commitment. That's the commitment of the Attorney General's office. That's a commitment of the men and women who stand behind me this afternoon. I want to close by emphasizing one point. New Jersey has some of the toughest gun laws in this country. You can't just walk into a store here, present your driver's license, and walk out with multiple guns, including assault rifles. We restrict gun sales, and we restrict gun sales to keep our residents safe and to keep our law enforcement officers safe. But other states, unfortunately, like Ohio, don't have similar procedures. There, it's easy to buy guns. And through the type of gun trafficking alleged in our indictments, those guns end up in New Jersey, where they're sold illegally and used in violent crimes. In fact, more than 3 out of 4 of the guns recovered in New Jersey in 2016 and traced by the ATF originated in other states. 61 of those guns recovered in 2016 originated in Ohio, making it the 8th largest distributor of illegal firearms recovered in New Jersey. We are committed to putting an end to this iron pipeline of illegal firearms coming into this state, whether it's from Ohio or whether other states where individuals are buying guns in this manner and then selling them to criminals on the streets in cities like Camden and elsewhere in New Jersey where they're being used in furtherance of violent crime. As Chief Thompson mentioned at the outset, these investigations don't happen by one agency acting alone. They are true collaborations. So I want to thank our federal partners, who Director Honig will specifically mention in a moment, but I want to thank them for their extraordinary cooperation during the course of this investigation. I want to thank the men and women of the New Jersey State Police, who work tirelessly each day to keep us safe, and who work tirelessly each day along with members of the Division of Criminal Justice, our Deputy Attorneys General, some of whom are here, to make sure that we remain safe by taking these types of drug trafficking rings down and taking these types of guns off our streets.